I think it's a great move for him and the organization. I think that I've always had a lot of respect for him. Always thought he was a fairly underrated player. Probably didn't get the respect that he deserved. Obviously was in a tough situation there with the Raiders, you know, based on a lot of the things that have happened there over the last few years. And I think he kind of caught the brunt of that unfairly. And I think you shoulder a lot of that burden as the quarterback anyway. So I think highly of him as a person. And he's shown the ability to execute, you know, complicated offenses where, you know, a lot is put on the quarterback position to be able to make checks and to make reads very quickly. And he's proven that. Obviously, a lot of that was Gruden's system with the Raiders, and we run a version of that, you know, with the West Coast. And I think he'll mesh well with Pete Carmichael. I think he's got some weapons around him. Excited that you know, Michael Thomas is going to be back and hopefully healthy. Man, he deserves that. And look, I think that they're going to be well positioned to make a run at it.
How hard is it, Drew, when you're on a team that's not winning and you're the quarterback?
Oh, it's really hard because, like I said, you take that personally. You shoulder a lot of that burden. You know, you feel like, and look, it's the reason why the quarterback position is so well compensated in the NFL. You know, that it's a lot is put on that position, and that position can make a huge difference. You know, it can shield a lot of other things. You know, but at the same time, you know, Marty Schottenheimer told me this one time, that the QB position is so unique in the NFL because it's the one position that has the ability to impact everyone around you in the most impactful way. But at the same time, things that happen around you can also impact you in a pretty significant way, right? You can be doing everything right. Left tackle blows a block. You get hit in the back. It's a sack fumble. You know, it shows up as a negative for you. That was out of your control. But, right? So it's kind of a fine balance that you walk there. I think we've seen just what a difference just one position can make on a team. Look at what Brady did for the Bucks, right? And obviously they brought in a lot of great players along with him, but you know, that can change the complexion of things very quickly.
Do you see parallels? I mean, people, besides the personal stuff, I mean, I think he's got 4 kids. I think, you know, it's time in his career, his stats are similar to yours when you got here.
Yeah.
Do you see parallels when people draw those, whether they're fair or unfair?
He's much more of a seasoned veteran than I was when I came here. And obviously I was coming off the injury and there was a lot of unknowns and a lot of uncertainties. I think for him, first off, I think leaving the situation that he was in and getting a fresh start was going to be a good thing anyway. But he's stepping into a situation where it's a great organization. It's an organization that will do whatever it takes to win and build the pieces around it, right? That's been proven. He has weapons at the receiver position, at the running back position. He's got a great defense, still a top-tier defense. And a defensive, you know, defensive-minded head coach, but with an offensive coordinator that's been in this system now for almost 20 years, right? So he just has all these things going for him, and I think he's at that point in his career, too, where it's that balance of enough experience and still playing at a high having all your physical capabilities, you know, where he's like, I call it prolonging your prime at the end of my career, right? Is how do you maintain the physical abilities while still having all of this experience and all of this kind of mental acuity? So he's at that point where he's got it all, and now here's the opportunity to really go and showcase it.
Seeing some of the money out there, you ever wish that you were 7 to 10 years later?
No, look, I mean, I had a chance to reap the benefits of the guys that came before me. And so I think for anyone to sit around and be bitter or what have you about the increasing salaries, no, we should take pride in that. We had a chance to be a part of that, but also we kind of rode on the backs of the guys that came before us. And that's the way it's designed to be. And that just means that we're continuing to push the league forward, push the game forward, and make it better for the next generation. That's what it's all about.
Are you going to be joining the PGA Tour anytime soon?
Well, if I could play every hole like I did that last hole, and if they move the tee boxes up, then yes, I could. Absolutely.
Do you feel, just from how last season unfolded, now it seems like they found their quarterback. Do you feel like this 7-9 season this past season was almost an anomaly? Maybe they could turn it around moving forward.
Well, it's never as easy just to look at the record and say they were a 7-9. It was a 7-9 season, so therefore they were a 7-9 team.
I think 7-10 season.
Yeah,
7-10.
Yeah, right. 17 games, right. I didn't get to, I didn't get a chance.
It's a 17th. Yeah, you never did either. Right, yeah.
But that's that. I think we would all recognize that. Look, I watched that Tampa game and I about threw something through the TV. I was so pissed off at the end of that game. Like we should win that game. We had three opportunities to win that game, right? And if you win that game, we win the division, and we're hosting a first round playoff game, and who knows what happens, you know? And then we're having a totally different conversation, right? But one game, one moment, one play can determine so much of your season, especially when you're kind of right on the fringe of, you know, being winning a division or being a wild card or what have you. So we're there. I mean, we're that close. We just need to catch some breaks, need to win some games that we're supposed to win, maybe win a few that we're not supposed to win, have some plays that just become defining moments for the season.
How did it feel to be back? I mean, do you always enjoy coming back for this? In Piercy and Palmer, I guess, are guys you'll be pulling for this week?
Absolutely, yeah. This is always a fun event. I mean, obviously it showcases a lot of great things about New Orleans. I eat way too much on the course. I get my fix with, you know, etouffee and Drago's oysters and a little Blue Oak barbecue, and that's all fun. Obviously it was a beautiful day. We missed Sean Payton today. Missed having Sean out here. He's always the life of the party. I've played with Palmer here for the last couple of years, and it's funny because we were in college roughly the same time. He went to Texas A&M, which was my dream school, right? So we always have a good laugh, you know, that A&M didn't recruit me. He's a great guy. It's funny because you get these opportunities to play with guys, and then you end up getting to know them a little bit, and then you start pulling for them, and it makes, you know, the weekend golf tournaments a bit more interesting.
A lot of comparisons between you and Bryce Young. People are bringing you up. When you hear that, what do you think?
Yeah, I think that the comparison's probably John, because, you know, he's, you know, considered undersized, right? Even more so, like, look, that used to be something that was really talked about a lot, but I think the 6 foot and under club has come through pretty strong, you know, over the last 20 years. And now all of a sudden you got a guy who's what, 5'10 and a half, 180 pounds? Right? Like, normally you would just look at that on paper and say, you know, no way. But the guy's going to be the first pick in the draft. All you have to do is turn on the tape, right? All you have to do is sit with him, which I had a chance to do for a couple hours this offseason. And you see he's a tremendous young man. He's extremely bright. Like, he's got such a high football IQ. His teammates love him. Like, he's a playmaker, right? And so the only question I've heard is, well, durability, right? Yeah, you're going to take some hits. Yeah, might need to bulk up a little bit, but at the end of the day, you can avoid a lot of those hits if you know where to go with football, if you get the ball out in time. He's shown the ability to make people miss in the pocket, right? So that helps with longevity. I really like him.
What are you going to do this fall?
I don't know. Well, I'm going to, besides coach my kids, watch my kids play, you know, be a part of stuff at the school. I've got a lot of business stuff going on, a lot of stuff with our foundation. So that stuff keeps me really busy. And, you know, fun projects here and there, playing a little pickleball. Matt Drops Pickleball Club, baby. Let's go, MLP. I keep myself busy.
You've been retired for a couple of years. If Coach Payton called and said, I need your help, would you take that phone call?
What kind of help?
December kind of help.
Huh?
No, I'm talking more behind the scenes. Like, would you ever, I mean, you coach your kids forever. Do you ever think of yourself as being a coach down the line?
I love coaching. I love coaching, but again, that's just a time commitment thing with where my kids are, right? I can't have my weekends taken up in the fall when that's when my kids are playing sports. It's when I have a chance to be around them. Look, I loved being a fan last year. I got to come to some Saints games, right? I got to go to some, you know, some Purdue games. I had a chance to go to high school football games on Friday nights, you know, and coach my kids. Like, that's what I live for right now. Like, that's my favorite thing in life. So I'm going to soak that up, and then we'll see. I'm not ruling anything out for the future, but the coaching lifestyle doesn't quite make sense for the family life right now.